Hola, people of the internet, it is I, Shade Gray. Welcome back to Let's Play Banjo-Kazooie. Some reason I can't get out of this Mexican accent. Very offensive Mexican accent, but whatever. Notes everywhere, notes. You know, what's the logic behind making the locks to your doors music? I don't understand it. Doesn't make any sense to me, but whatever. God, scarabs. Flesh-eating monster. Insects. Hellish. There we go. Alright. So, last time in Shifting Sandland, we got a little bit done, but not too much. I really don't have much to talk about right now. Middle Arms is going a lot better than this at the moment. That's only because we're about to get to the really, really big climax of the game. We've got like 5 parts left. Yeah, completely and honest, I accidentally missed, numbered the parts when I was editing them. Instead of going to 30, I went to 29. Or instead of going to 29, I went to 30. So that's why the episode count has been off for just a tiny bit. That's due to my own ineptitude. But at the moment, in this game, we're just kind of collecting notes. While we're hovering several inches off the ground because this model just doesn't make any sense. Oh, and for anybody who's wondering, yes, I'm going to use the cheats in Banjo-Tooie when I get around to that game. God, I got so many Let's Plays planned, it's not even funny. After these two get finished, I'll put up a update video describing how the channel's gonna work from now on. God, that's gonna be a headache. It'll also have a list of all the Let's Plays I have planned up to this date. So anyway, how are you guys? Enjoying the playthroughs? I'm glad. I am so glad everyone's enjoying these playthroughs. Oh my God, can I get to a jiggy, please? Alright, back up to the only fly pad in this. Well, okay, one of like two. And cactus. I know there's a honeycomb piece in the middle of that, and it's not there. Where is it? Do I have to fly through it in order to get it? Ow! Rick! Oh well, I guess I can just fly up to the top of this pyramid over here and hit this switch, and hopefully that'll make something happen. Oh right, I remember this. This is another one of those time things. Ah, yes. God, I hate this puzzle. Well, I don't hate this puzzle, but now I've got everything memorized due to the frickin'. You'll see. You'll all see. There's a mumbo token in here. It's not really that important. I have more than enough mumbo tokens collected to get through the end of the game. You have 100 seconds to match up the 4 tiles. Yeah, it's this annoying memory game where you gotta figure out where everything is in order to complete the puzzle. But to be fair, there are only 8 matches, so it's not that bad. But it does take a while to remember where exactly all the matches are. But there is this weird and strange pattern to it all, if you pay attention. It's just kinda odd how the algorithm here works. As you can see, once you get the pattern, or once you identify the pattern, you can pretty much just figure out where everything is. And the musical note is not right there. I don't know what I was doing. Jinjo, Jinjo, note, note, and then Jiggy. Booyah! Oh, another little note before we head out the door. I changed my mind. By popular demand, and by that I mean one person, I'm leaving in the, I'm editing around what the characters say again. My wrist is gonna be killing me. But that's what the fans wanted, so I give the fans what they want. The Let's Plays are mine, and you can make suggestions all you want, but if you prefer how I'm doing something, I'll continue doing it that way. But yes, now we've made the honeycomb appear, which means that we now have to go back to that fly pad. Yay. That's great, isn't it? By the way, I love how the animation in this makes the Sphinx head looks like it's not even connected to the Sphinx at all. It's just so jarring from the back angle. Well, okay, from the back it doesn't look that bad, but from the front it looks absolutely horrible. By the way, if you ever want to get through a level quickly, don't be afraid to beat Mirage as long as it's not towards the ground. That is the worst thing you can possibly do. But in order to get this honeycomb piece, you don't actually have to beat Bomb, you just have to fly through it. It's pretty simple. There's another, Slappa. Which, again, you can beat by just waiting for it to ground pound. Or, waiting for it to pound to get to the ground, and then ground pound to get yourself. But here's Gooey! Yeah, that's a relatively simple fix right there. Sorry about that. And, no, I don't make it and I get pushed back. Not good, not good, not good, not good, not good. I make it. Okay. I can't die. I can't die. Really should have just faked him out, but whatever. Alright, I don't think there's anything else to do by this pyramid. Oh, wait, no. Alright. I don't remember ever seeing the dialogue for what a beehive says when it's surrounded by bees, but it's essentially, after. Well, I think at this level, I don't think there was one in Freeze Easy Peak, because bees don't usually survive in snow. But, every time you break open a beehive that has bees surrounding it, the bees will try and kill you. That's nice of them, right? And over here. Yes, that is King Grandma, leader of the hands. He's the only one with a jiggy, so I have to imagine he's the leader, but whatever. By the way, have you noticed the theme in this level? I mean, I know it's in Egypt, but there's only like one enemy that's even remotely not undead. And that's the scarabs. And even they were found in sarcophagus because they actually eat, you know, flesh. But whatever. level, you'd think they'd come up with different ideas besides mummies, more mummies, scarabs, and worms. But regardless, now we're going to get one of those stupid timed jiggies where you have to get inside the building before the door closes, or Gruntilda decides to, you know, ruin your day. So, what you do is you step on this switch right here. You don't actually have to grind on it, you just have to step on it. But I would suggest going up here beforehand, or after you get the jiggy, just because that makes it a whole heck of a lot easier. Grab the collectibles quickly, because there is an extra man, and there are, of course, notes. And since, if you're a klepto, you'll try and grab the notes before you walk your way up. I'm just gonna let the timer run out here because in order to beat this, you need to get the shoes. Because remember, guys, if you have any athletic potential, it must be the shoes. Yes, I had to work the timer for something. Such a dick move, making the cutscene last through the timer. You think the timer would start after the cutscene? That makes you think you have an extra 5 seconds, where in reality, you don't. You don't have an extra 5 seconds. You have 20 seconds to work your way up here, not 25. That's just annoying, guys. And it takes all of them to get up here. By the way, this room's a little cheap. There's a mumbo token back here. If you drain the water, that is impossible to get, so I would suggest getting it before you drain the water. These mummies are pretty much invincible until you pick up this jiggy and drain the water out of the room, like so. This is also the safest way to access this little middle area down here, which means we're almost done with this level, having 7 jiggies. That means all we have to do is, get one more, or get, the jiggy in the middle pyramid, and collect all the gingos. Wait, I'm missing a jiggy. Missing a jiggy. 7, 8, 9. I'm missing a jiggy. I can't believe it. I can't remember one of the jiggies. I think you get... Oh, you might get one for raising the pyramid. That's right. Alright, speaking of raising the pyramid, what you have to do that is, shoot some, eggs into these statues. Surprised yet? It's not like we've seen these statues before and get to shoot eggs into them. Well, actually, you only have to shoot 2 eggs in there. But you have to shoot 2 eggs into 3 different statues, so you have to spend 6 eggs in total, but that's not too bad, I suppose, for getting 2/3 jiggies, depending on if you have all the gingos at this point. But if you have the eggs cheat, it's not that bad. Every time you shoot eggs into a statue, the pyramid raises up just a little bit, and the statue moves. The next statue moves a little bit faster, so this can be slightly annoying, but if you're persistent at it long enough, you should be able to get it. And if you've noticed, each of the platforms gets a little bit smaller and a little bit lower. Get a jiggy for raising the pyramid, then I'm missing one that I can't think of. Anyway, down here are some notes. That's why you want to raise up the water level. There's also a Jinjo down here, apparently. Luigi and Joe for the water. Get it? Eh? Get it? Yeah. The tree. That's right. The jiggy at the beginning of the level. Now I remember. How did I forget that one? The whole reason you have to release Go. The whole reason? Really? What did I turn Jewish? Anyway. So, yeah. Let's go inside the pyramid. Or, as the game knows it as, the pyramid, the tomb of Sandy Butt. Don't you love comedy? That's important later. Bring it, you undead piece of toilet paper. Alright, take two of this section. As I was saying, this is King Sandy Butt's maze. The only really dick thing that they do in this entire level is that they put the wind switch on the other side of the maze. So, in order to get the jiggy for shifting sand, you have to go to this side of the maze and then work your way back to the door. So, you still have all the time. For new players, you might still kick the bucket once, but there is a Jinjo in one of these pots, so I would suggest jumping in there at some point. There we go. And that'll get you your first of two jiggies in here. The second one being, of course, the main jiggy that we came in here for. And now we only have one left for the rest of the level. This was actually located at the beginning of the level. You can get it any time after freeing Gobi. Because Gobi is required for two other jiggies in this game. And if you didn't free Gobi in this game, the second game doesn't make much sense. Sharing and caring, you rooster. Some gifts. After slamming a Gobi's back, you will see that Trunkers grows up a little bit. But weirdly enough, this is the only tree in the game that you can't actually climb. You have to go all the way back to the Sphinx over here and fly over to Trunkers and pick up the jiggy. But before doing that, I would suggest flying over to that area that I mentioned before. Now, I know some of you were probably thinking, oh, you meant that thing at the end? No, I meant this. I'm not talking about that thing that happens at the end of the game. There are notes and a honeycomb. And nothing. Now, because as I've beaten the game on this file before, you see that the door is open. It's not always the case. The door is usually closed for first-time players, so if that's throwing anybody off, don't worry about it. And this was kind of retarded. But whatever. Now we gotta get back to the fly pad in order to get that jiggy that we unlocked with Trunkers. By the way, Gobi moves really fast. I mean, I know that's just for coding purposes, but I'd actually like to see him, you know, move. And how does he get to the places that he gets to? That's what I don't know. By the way, if you're wondering what he meant by the lava world, that's not addressed until the next game, so I wouldn't, wreck your brain about it too much. Anyway, you have to fly to the top of Trunkers in order to get the jiggy. I've said this about 3 times now, but whatever. You get the jiggy and you can leave. Next time on Banjo-Kazooie, we advance to the next world. Awesome, right? I hate the next world. Full of enemies I can't kill.